if you introspect and look back, that in January I had made you all aware that there are going to be subtle changes. So in the month of July, I'm actually reminding you once again, if you all haven't made the changes, please make the changes. But these changes can only be made if you are deliberate and you are prepared with an open mind to recalibrate yourself, to redetermine yourself and to re-strategize and probably look into the pattern of your life. And if the changes are to be made, you can make them both personally and professionally. And a gentle reminder that whatever changes you make now, once the Jupiter goes direct in August and Saturn goes direct in September, you will actually see the benefits and you will actually see that how rewarding these changes can be. To add on again, I would say a little contemplation. In July, there are two major eclipses coming in. And there is also the retrograde of Mercury, which actually is advising you that now is the time to contemplate, to introspect, rather than hone your communication skills. So you don't have to be angry, you don't have to be aggressive, you don't have to give it back immediately because your tongue is going to tickle quite a bit. So controlling your tongue, controlling your communications is going to be very, very rewarding. And the best way, rather than feeling stressed out that, oh my God, I, because of the eclipses or because of the Mercury retrograde, I have to again control myself. My answer to you would, no, you don't have to control yourself. You just need to go inward. And probably meditation is the best outlet because it will not only make you mentally stronger, but it will also help you know what is the shape that you want to give to your life for the next couple of years. Now, Taurus, the month of July 2019 for you. Well, this month Venus runs in Taurus. So love, affection, warmth and intimacy are going to be affecting you greatly. None of these have to be problematic. If you have a positive mind and beneficial and good intentions, then all these activities can actually create a positive karma for you. Build a positive relationship with any of your partner, personal or professional. Awakened Taurians love to be grounded and practical. So this month, look at your own face to see the blemishes. Be introspective. Be truthful to yourself and be honest. Don't look at others. That is too easy and never benefits anyone unless you have a strong, empathetic compassion. In regards to the monthly overview, you should take a long walk back in your memory and try to remember the last time being pompous and condescending, which got you what you wanted. You can't remember a single time that being pompous and condescending actually got what you wanted. Well, then learn from that and be nice now. That's the recalibration and re-strategizing for you. Make a date with a friend you haven't seen lately. Your deep understanding of a loved one's psychological makeup will make it very easy for you to ease the tensions. Truly wonderful and quite possibly very romantic days brighten your days by the mid-month. If single, romance tip-taps at your window by the end of the month, throw it open, help guide it up the trails, embrace it with open arms, and once it is in, you are going to be deliriously happy. And this follows in your love and relationships also, that if you want to be successful in making healthy progress in a romantic relationship, then either you should think only about yourself and your needs, or think only about them and their needs, or none of the above. Well, the correct answer is none of the above. And the final answer is think about your respective needs, communicate and come to a conclusion that you both can live with. So it requires a lot of communication skills. Career, the best way to get what you really want at work is by being as agreeable as possible. Smile, say please, offer to do them a favor next time they need one. So get inspired for a work project by exposing yourself to some serious culture. Being psychological savvy makes life at your workplace a lot easier. Just three words that you need to use are please, may I, and thank you. These three things can make life very easy for you in your professional area. Taurus needs to keep your finances under control by the 17th. After all, if you spend too much, you won't be relaxed and calm at work. The wonderful news opens up several new doors for you. So wait for that lovely news. In regards to your health and fitness, well, I suggest that you know what you need when it comes to your fitness. You need to work out. You need to work out regularly. You need to eat well. You need to sleep well. You need to be okay with yourself on all basic levels, that is emotionally and financially and physically. So your focus should be on healing, nurturing, and just plain fostering your health, be it physical, mental, emotional, or spiritual. So you don't always need to be implementing something new. If your old fitness routine is working for you, be at it, but be regular. Pay attention to any or all little aches and pains if they're telling you something about yourself. Try cutting out on bad habits. Taurus, you'll need to follow through on at least one health resolution this month, because you need to re-strategize and rediscipline yourself in the month of July 2019. For the best days, for your career days, for your honey days, for your money days, and for your love and romantic days, you definitely have to visit my website. Now, this year has been very, very significant because of so many retrogrades and so many shadowy planets that have been hovering around our chart. So it's very important for you all to revert back to your natal charts, to actually see what talents you were born with, what was your destiny, and how you can re-strategize, recalibrate, and redetermine your goals and your ambitions in life. So this year is like a change which can be definite, a change which can be better for you guys, but only the awareness and then getting the change is going to be beneficial. But if you're just going to expect changes to happen in your life, then chances are those changes may actually not be good. So please be aware of your natal chart. Please go through your natal charts, and you need to know what is the pattern of your life, what is the pattern that the life is taking, and do you need to change those patterns in your life? Because eventually, life is what you make it. So the thoughts that you have in your mind are the ones that are going to be put into action, and action is what will determine your fate. So changing your fate, shaping your destiny through the talents, by knowing it through your natal chart, will do you a world of good.